There's a few questions I have about developers. Like, I remember when Nezon Productions, the maker of Formata, I was like, whatever happened to Formata? Why didn't they make a second Formata? And they did. And it was called Shieldwall, and it's awesome, and it's being updated. But whatever happened to Insane Dreamers, the developers of Home Wars? They made this game, and it was pretty good at a fundamental level. I mean, it's one of the few true epic base defense for Green Plastic Army Men. And honestly, one of the best base defense building games there is. But they disappeared, and we don't know where they are. Because look at this custom battle. Now, in the last video, I asked if you guys wanted to see more Home Wars, and it's got, 9,000 likes and over 300,000 views. So I think the answer is yes, but if you guys do want to see more, you know what to do. Pull the trigger and like button. Let me know in the comments. Custom battles, because in the last one, people were talking about, hey, Baron, we didn't really get to see too many jumpy boys. Now, there's a lot of bugs here. Some flyers, some crawlers, some creepy, creepy spiders. But there's also jumpy boys. Where are you, jumpy boys? Here you go. Gryllus campestris and Grasshopperus hoppius. No, Locusta migratoria. Wow. Migratory locust. That's literally what their name means. Now, are there any other high tier locusts? Yes. Romalia guttata. Did you imagine a bunch of like fancy hoity-toity sitting around drinking their tea? What should we name this bug? Maybe Romalia guttata. But anyway, we're gonna have to be fighting these Romulegatatus. That's how I like to call them. Ooh, who's this big boy? Hermadina Thoracia. Cause it kind of does have a charm if you use like a little bit of country boy accent. Anyway, I'm having way too much fun. So we're gonna have Gryllus campestris, a Plessicum partum. Now let's find a good old battlefield. Kid's bedroom seems good enough. All right. Now, if we're going to be fighting jumpy boys, do you think any aircraft infantry are going to work well? You know what we will need? Heavy riflemen. Now, it says I can start right now. I think that's a poor idea. We're going to need sappers for sure. I think this thing just looks awesome. I need to see if it actually shoots at terrestrial bugs as well as bugs in the air. And if they're hopping around, we're going to want at least one heavy attack chopper. We're going to need support vehicles. We need supply trucks. You better believe it. Shotguns are always good against aerial targets. When I shoot at ducks, I bring shotguns. And then our supporting cast of the cannon fodder units known as riflemen. Is it enough? Probably not. I always love these little screenshots. They were pretty good, man. There's a giant horn in the background and a Chinook. Now, the key to a good base defense is have the units that are going to be building the base that you are going to be defending out front so that they can go do a good job. We do not have a lot of units. This could be bad. We've only got one of these things, which they look pretty impressive. Now, can this survive? What we're going to do? Start the battle and pause. Because this is what I'm talking about. This is why it's one of the best base defending games out there. These bugs don't like glue. So what if I was to just cover the battlefield with glue? And this guy, you know what? Do we want jumping mines? They're going to be jumping. We're going to be jumping too. We got jumping mines. Oh man, I don't know if that's a good idea. That's a lot of mines. They call them mines. And then you can build sandbags. Well, that could have been different because now I have backward sandbags. You sandbagging son of a biscuit. And then we got these shelters, which are going to be pretty good because they are going to be dropping in from the sky. So we're going to have barbed wire on the ceiling for when they jump through it. All right, so everybody's going to be moving out, and now we've got about 84 seconds here. So, supply truck, you guys will supply in the middle. Now, these guys are going to be able to heal. I feel like there could be an ambulance type of unit, as well as resupply their ammunition. Now, I'm really hoping this is going to be the star of the show. Big, heavy gun, boy. So, we're going to put these guys in the bags. All right. So we're still putting down these fortifications. One of the things that could have been a quality of life update is if it's not built, it's kind of translucent whitish. And if it's done, well, then it's obviously the color of your army men. Here, we're using the classic green because we ain't no dirty tans. All right, we're the good guys. Green always seemed like the good guys and tan were always the bad guys, at least in the 3DO army men games of recent history. So let's go ahead. I think we're almost ready. Yeah, actually, we've got a few guys out there. Yeah, I think it's go time. All right, so it's gonna take a little bit of time for them to kind of appear. Apparently, we can't see giant bugs. The sight distance is a little bit low. I feel like I'd be able to see them by now. You know what we could do? Send out the scout chopper. Where are these hoppy boys at? Oh my God, they're hopping in already. Okay, that's one of the big ones. Oh my God. Okay. So that is huge. Okay. You're an army man this big and there's a giant cricket. He looks like he could just chomp you in half and he probably could. One of them, I think, tried to jump at the helicopter. But one of the things I do like about this game is by pressing Q, you get to take control of the selected unit. Now, who do I want to be? Hey! Oh yeah, you're hit because look at that. Oh God. Oh, that's his attack animation. I feel like if they had attack animations and some like physics, like, oh God, this guy just killed two of my friends. Son, you need to get behind the wire. They're hopping around. Ah, look at, okay. We did not get enough defenders here. Oh God, I'm reloading. Oh man. Okay, he's dead, I think. Is he dead? You better be dead, bug. Oh, he's not dead, he's hopping. The mines are going off, but now they're not even bothering hopping anymore. They're just running. Retreat! Okay, so what would we do to increase the survivability? The helicopter's still flying. We could get some better air power. I'm running around in a minefield because I've got a death witch. I mean, honestly, I know I'm gonna die because they're already just storming the base. Now, you can't jump, which is unfortunate. I feel like you should be able to jump. Charles, look behind you. There's a bug biting your booty. And Charles is like, I'm a plastic armor man. I don't feel. But actually, they might. They might feel. I mean, no one's ever bothered to ask them. Do the horrors of war scare you, soldier? Do they scare you? Okay, we need an immediate withdrawal. Objective failed, they say, huh? We'll see about that. We're going back to the drawing board. Now, what we need... I wish it also, like, saved your most recent one, right? So, let's see. We had, like, 20 of these guys. Logosta migratoria, Hermodinia thoracia, Romulagatete, and Schizophrenia Gregorian chanting. All right, we need better weaponry this time. Mechs. We're gonna bring the new technology of army men. We're gonna have automatic grenade launchers. We're gonna have flamethrowers because bugs do not like fire. Some heavy machine guns. Definitely want our sappers. I don't think the big machine gun was firing. We'll get two 150 millimeter howitzers, light artillery, and just for fun, one ground attack warthog. Because look at those things, man. They got the bird. So there we go. They're in the control tower. We'll put them in groups of five. That seems like a pretty solid squad for mech warriors. I didn't put 9, I put 10. We have a glitch in the matrix. Dude, look at the mechs walking. That's pretty dope. So now we just gotta move all of our units out. And there's no real easy way or kind of organized way to do it. Now, these are the shotgun boys, so you're gonna stay close to the building. And then we'll just divvy out our infantry. I really like, I mean, granted, one's an indie game and the other one's just like super professional, but I really like the Total War ability to kind of set unit formations, which by the way, Warhammer 3 Total War was just announced and I am so freaking hyped for that. They announced Cathay. For those of you who are fans of Warhammer lore, Cathay didn't exist. And they're like, you know what? We're gonna make them exist. All right, boys, get in a position. We got aerial mines just in case they jump high enough, which I think is a little bit unnecessary. You too, get behind the wire. Pathfinding appears to be a bit of an issue. All right, now I'm kind of curious to see what a mech is like. Okay, I've got lasers, rotary cannons, and 40 millimeter grenade launchers. So the movement is a little whack, but it makes sense for mechs. So these little barbed wire things aren't the easiest. Okay, they're coming in. Let's use a laser. Oh. Okay, I was expecting a little more epic, but this is pretty cool too. It's a blue laser. There we go. Oh, there's big boy. Oh, what? Use a grenade launcher. We gotta defend. Oh man, this thing is great. You see my grenades just going off? You can tell they're mine because they're not really detonating very close to the enemy. I'm super accurate. All right, and then, whoops, I didn't mean to press Q. I meant to press 1 so I could use my rotary cannons. Why does it look like it's aiming up? Son, okay, you know what? I'm gonna let you do your thing. Okay, now they're firing accurately. That's interesting. Is that a bug or a feature? These are bugs. That was also a bug. Or rather, these are features. Okay, so you know what time it is. We're gonna call in the A-10 Warthog. So it immediately comes out and fires its 30 millimeter autocannon and just takes out some of these big hoppy boys. I'd say this battle is going rather well for us. Look at that, man. Seeing them all just hop and bum rush the lines. Oh God, we don't have anyone protecting the artillery. We need a unit to protect artillery. Everybody else is hanging out here. Now, are these guys supplied? Yeah, they are. Okay, good. They're kind of actually double supplied. You guys can move in. That way they'll be healed, right? Oh, and there's the flamethrowers. Let's try to be one of these guys. Hey, you want to get nuked, you dirty bugs? And then one of the guys just like, you know what? I'm going to go a little bit Rambo today. Win the battle? Not yet. I'm gonna torch these. We're gonna eat like I did in Thailand many, many, many years ago. We're gonna have roasted bugs. Hey, what are you guys doing out here? Are you getting ready to hop? Or are you just like, you know what? Sometimes, as a bug, I question, why are we here? Why are we fighting? Out of reach. Oh, look at that. That's cool. Am I in reach yet? I should be in reach. There we go. Ah! And is he dead? Yes. Uh-oh. Incoming artillery. Well, we did good. We did really good. All right. I remember taking command of planes was super, super difficult, but this is where we are right now, right? So we did the Hoppy Boys challenge. We did the Hoppy Boys. If you have some other battles that you would like to see, let me know, because honestly, let's see what the armored airship does. I haven't used that guy in a while. And then the big artillery, and we're just gonna have them against like massive amounts of regular ants. Now we gotta make sure these guys are supplied. So we'll have some supply trucks and then we'll have some recon vehicles to protect. Yeah, 50 times, how many are in this? 20, so that's 1,000? Is that 1,000 bugs? Warning, they have a high impact on performances. You know what, max allies on screen, let's mix up all of this. 500 at a time. Oh, look at those Harrier strike aircraft and giant tarantulas. Okay, so this is gonna be pretty easy because, oh my God, that cannon's huge. Okay, and then you got these guys to protect it and then just tons of trucks to keep everything alive and hopefully well-armed. There we go. And then I don't have any infantry. Everything's doubt. So we're starting battle and we're ready. Okay, here are the airships. Oh God, yeah, let's put them out a little bit. Now, what if I take command of, okay. I don't know what I'm looking at right there when I took command of him. Okay, here we go. That's a little bit better, but I can't. All right, and if I do triple cannon, does it change? No, this is not very user friendly, shall we say. Okay, so there should just be, look, hundreds of ants, right? So let's get down here. Low to the Groja here. You just see all the ants start rendering in and boom! Big boy artillery. That's something out of some like World War II German experiments or like old school Saddam. You know what I'm saying? They used to always try to build, I'm going to build a giant artillery piece. And that's, they just woke up, had a good glass of coffee and are like, yeah, that's what I'm gonna try to do today. So these ants are getting in close, man. I thought these airships would be doing a little bit more. It's kind of like an AC-130 gunship. Like, so I'd imagine that's Vulcan machine gun. We got triple cannons and that is clearly the laser. Oh, okay. We're doing some advanced maneuvering here. Kirov reporting. And the ants are bum rushing. I don't know actually if they're going to be able to survive. Yeah, there's just too much. We probably needed some greater air defense or rather better air assets. You know, other planes and attack helicopters to bring in because these ants are now chewing away at the base that we're supposed to protect. All of these things fire a little too slowly, but when they do fire, they bring down the pain train. Now, if we increase this to 4x speed, actually 2x speed, who wins? Oh, we're actually losing lots of trucks. They tried to retreat. Guys, you just have to kill all the ants. Oh no, we got defeated. Okay, even the simplest of ants. Quantity does have a quality all its own. But this is Home Wars. It's one of the best Green Army Men base building and base defense games. You can see it's rough around the edges, but it definitely has its merits. It's awesome. It's available on Steam. But I just beg to wonder, like, why wasn't there ever a second Home Wars? It blows my mind. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Pull the trigger on the like button if you did enjoy Home Wars and you'd like to see more. Subscribe if you're new. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.